Hello, and welcome to TechFix, where we bring the latest issues and solutions straight from the field. This TechFix will zero in on a topic that's been causing more than a few headaches in shops across the country. Vehicle modes, battery drain, and no starts in the all-new Volvo VNL. We're digging into the new logic around key placement, how power shuts down, how to avoid battery surprises, and why knowing how these systems behave could save hours of unnecessary diagnostics. Everything we're covering is backed by the CBRs shown on the screen. So let's get into it. First thing to understand, this truck doesn't just turn on and off. It moves through a series of modes designed to balance performance and power conservation. Each mode changes how the vehicle behaves and how much energy is consumed. One that catches a lot of technicians is pre-delivery mode. That one comes active from the factory. It disables several features such as keyless entry, HVAC, infotainment, basically anything that would drain the battery during transport. You'll see pre-delivery mode in the cluster. Here's how to disable it. Unlock the driver's door manually with the key. To enter accessory mode on trucks with start-stop button, tap the start without pressing the brake. On keyed trucks, turn counterclockwise to accessory or ACC. Press and hold the hazard button for about 5 to 10 seconds. The pre-delivery mode message will disappear. That's your only confirmation. From there, the vehicle runs through other states. Parked mode keeps the truck in a minimal wake state. Doors and lights work, but that's about it. Living mode is where drivers camp out. It keeps bunk lights, AC, and the radio on. Depending on the cab type, it stays active for 2 or 12 hours before reverting to parked. Accessory mode gives control over things like mirrors and windows, but leaves the drivetrain off. Pre-run powers up the entire system, ideal for diagnostics or software updates. Always set the HVAC blower to zero first to avoid issues. Crank mode is just what it sounds like. The starter engaged and some accessories may drop momentarily. Run mode is the full normal operation. Alternator charging and full electrical loads are available. Before programming software, remove unnecessary draws. Set the HVAC blower speed to zero. Make sure the inverter and fridge are turned off. That's it. Now, let's talk about timers. Timers vary by key location and truck configuration. With the key out of the ignition or fob outside of the truck, you've got 30 minutes before it enters parked mode. If the fob is inside the sleeper cab, it could stay in living mode for up to 12 hours. If the key is in the ignition, you're looking at 2 hours on a day cab or 12 hours on higher cab variants before entering parked mode. If the hood or doors open during this time, the timer will reset. Here's a simple guide to help you remember. Key removed, 30-minute shutdown. Key inserted, 2 to 12 hours depending on cab. Fob outside, 30 minutes. Fob inside, 2 to 12 hours. One of the most common causes of battery drain is key placement. This truck behaves differently depending on whether you've got a traditional key or a start-stop button. It also matters whether the fob is inside of the truck or out. With the start-stop button system, keep the fob off the wireless charge plate. Placing it on the wireless charge plate can interrupt the signal, so essentially, it wouldn't even recognize that the fob was even in the cab. Keeping the fob on or near the antenna will keep the truck from entering park mode. While driving, you can keep the fob in your pocket, on the dash, in a cup holder, honestly, anywhere except on the charger pad. Again, if you do, the truck won't even recognize it. Trucks with a traditional key rely on a mechanical switch, not a chip. When the key is inserted, it trips a switch inside the ignition cylinder. When you aren't driving, store the traditional key anywhere you want except leaving it in the ignition cylinder. Now, to one of the most important systems on this truck, the battery saver system. This is Volvo's built-in protection against parasitic loads, draining the battery when the truck sits too long. There are 4 hardware setups: dash switch, battery box switch, remote key fob activation, and timer-only version. The basic behavior is consistent. After 2 hours of inactivity, it cuts power to the climate system, mirrors, wipers, and windows. At the 12-hour mark, it cuts door locks, dome lights, sleeper power, and the fridge. If the driver doesn't manually trigger anything, it handles this on its own, based purely on timers and conditions. There are manual overrides too. On trucks with a chassis-mounted switch, vertical is on, disconnect active, horizontal is off, normal use. The truck won't start if that switch is set to on. Same function on the dash-mounted version, it's just easier to get to. With the remote key fob setups, double-pressing the lock button triggers disconnect. Next, let's talk about the inverter, one of the most overlooked causes of battery drain on this truck. Even when the truck's shut down, the inverter can stay on if the system didn't detect a state change. That includes scenarios like pulling shore power without cycling the key, or leaving the truck off but never fully powering down. If the inverter light is on, it's drawing power. Flip it off before walking away. If you're storing your truck long term, remove all fobs from the cab. Set the battery saver switch to on. Turn off the inverter in the fridge. Make sure the state of charge is at least 80%. And if you're planning a software update, we want to get that to 85%. Also, don't assume shore power is helping unless the inverter's actually wired up to use it. One thing to remember with the HVAC system, when engaging the parking climate from the fob, the truck remembers the last temperature set, but not the fan speed. Let's finish with one of the more confusing features on the truck, proactive engine restart. It can be triggered by a dash-mounted flexible switch. When activated, the truck monitors battery voltage. If it gets too low, it'll automatically start the engine, recharge, then shut down again. For the flexible switch to work, the following conditions must be met. The key must be off or in the accessory position, fob inside of the truck, doors and hood closed, fuel above 12.5%, parking brake on, gear in neutral, and pedals not pressed. If even one of those conditions isn't met, it won't activate. Another feature to be aware of is remote start. Remote start with the fob is only available on certain models. You lock the truck, then hold the auxiliary button for 3 seconds. But even then, some units won't remote start, even though the same fob will still control the locks and the parking heater. If it's not working, check that the doors and hood are closed, that there's enough fuel in the truck, transmission in neutral, your parking brake is applied, and that the proactive engine restart switch isn't already active. This system is powerful, but it only works if you understand the rules. Knowing what mode the truck is in, where the key should live, and how each mode behaves is the difference between a tech who chases battery drain for hours and one who fixes it in 5 minutes. That's it for this TechFix topic. Pass this on to the rest of your shop. It'll save someone's Saturday call out. Catch you next time on TechFix.